2014. He came out and he had this cute little furrowed brow and looked sort of concerned about the new world he was in. One of the first things Drew said after Major was born was he won't take the bottle. And I didn't think anything of it because I was a new mom and we had a lot to learn. But little did we know Major was desperately trying to tell us something that was going to change our lives forever.
Major's birth, it slowly became clear to us as well as his doctors that something was wrong. Being new parents, we didn't really realize just how sick he looked until we looked back at it months later.
And after two nights in labor and delivery, our worst fears started to come true. He had to be admitted to NICU, and we thought he had an intestinal blockage, something that surgery could fix, which he was about 3 days old when the tone in the room just started to change, and words like newborn screen and prenatal screening started to be thrown around, and I knew what that meant. We were dealing with something we couldn't fix.
That was the moment when our world really started to crumble down around us. I called one of my best friends, and I was shocked when I just broke down from a place inside of me that I really had no idea ever existed.
Major was diagnosed with cystic fibrosis when he was just 7 days old. And we quickly learned that CF is a genetic lung disease that also causes a very sticky mucus in the lungs and also causes severe digestive issues, which he was having.
So instead of Jaci getting the chance to enjoy a relaxing maternity leave, she spent her time at the hospital once a week for weight checks. We both learned how to perform manual chest percussions just to break the mucus up in his lungs. We learned how to give our infant pills, 7 a day to be specific. Most people will never know how hard that is. Just when we thought we could relax for a moment, Major turned out to need a nebulizer. So, not for a week or two, but something he'll need forever.
Over the course of Major's first year of life, there were so many happy moments, seeing him first smile, laugh, rolling over, sitting up, standing, walking, he's starting to talk. We've also had a lot of pain. When Major is healthy, we still have to give him up to 14 pills a day just so he can digest his food. He has to take asthma medication, do 1 hour of nebulizer and percussion treatments. And at just 8 months old, he had to have his first bronchoscopy where doctors go in and took a sample out of his lungs and clean out all that extra mucus. Unfortunately, these procedures are routine for people with cystic fibrosis. And you begin to realize how much your life has just changed when instead of just being proud that they can walk, you're proud that they can take their vest off, that they can hold their nebulizer. Major doesn't want to do treatments. He wants to play. And how can we explain to him that more treatments equals more play? He doesn't know that without him, he would die before grade school.
At this point, obviously, you know, we can't imagine our lives without Major. He is one of the strongest fighters of a little child, and he takes everything in stride. He has no idea how strong he is. And we know that we're gonna have to tell him about this, that he's trying to win this battle every day. We're gonna have to explain to him the importance of just treatments and nutrition, and that this is his life.
How do we explain to him that without compliance, he'll shorten his life significantly, and that even with compliance to treatment, he still might shorten it rather significantly? The average life expectancy for someone with CF is only 40 years old. And how can I tell him that at 20, he might be at his midlife? His life would be half over. I mean, do you remember when you were 20, what you were doing? You had your whole life ahead of you. We're so lucky that the work of the CF Foundation has gotten that life expectancy to 40, but that's not good enough.
Donations are what are make us allowable to increase the years on his life. Research gains greater understanding and will eventually find a cure for Major as well as everyone else. So just please help us so we can tell Major that this battle is over before he even knows that it started. Your donations will help add tomorrows for the lives of people with CF.